evening, everyone. My name is Nilaza. I'm a second year law student here at University of Kent. My slam poetry that I wrote is on the topic of brain drain, and I think it's a very relevant topic in our day and age today, because we live in a generation where we're all constantly moving towards the West and towards foreign countries in search of a better life. But in doing that, we end up abandoning our country, and we sometimes don't tend to understand the impact this might have on our country. Before I start my poem, I just want to thank a few people. I want to thank my parents for flying all the way out here to watch me perform. I want to thank Shraddha Gurung and Priyanka Shrestha for helping me bring this poem to life. And last but not the least, I would like to dedicate this poem to my maternal grandparents here in Sushila Udas, and my paternal grandparents, Basundara and Shobhakar Adhikari. Thank you. This is great. I want to take you back to the age, you know, when you were young and you ran around the streets eating chatpate, and when Dasai came around, your elders blessed you saying, "Tulo, eh, Dr. Engineer Bonner," and your goal was to maybe one day study in the UK. Story time. Let me tell you what happened to Sita. Her sister's name was Geeta. She watched her sister move to America. Oh, the West, the land of opportunities where everything was the best. Geeta advised Sita to go to the UK. It's easier to settle and a good place to stay. I mean, Nepal had become like so totally corrupted anyways. Geeta promised Sita a better life with better education and drinkable water straight from the tap. She said, "Why stay in Nepal when you can travel like anywhere you want on the map?" Sita moved here and realized that this was one privileged life she was going to live. And as the days passed, she forgot about her past, about who she was or where she came from. She wore a friend lovely every day, hoping that she could rub the brown off. And she even stopped to pray. Not because she didn't believe in God, but because she was ashamed to be associated with a religion that others found quite odd. And even though she didn't believe in God, she continued to cry, "For God's sake, Hazurama, I'm not coming back to Nepal. Na kaam garnu na padnu. Keti bhayera kam ta garo chha mero jivan. Keti bhayera kam ta garo chha mero jivan." And while all this is being said and done, her mother remains stern and she says, "Ho chori, timi jasto padhi lekheko keti ko kehi kaam chaina Nepalma. Go further your education, use that, and why don't you earn?" Sita educates herself and declares herself a feminist, and she decides to march. But she doesn't quite understand that in the West, feminism calls for equal pay and maternity rights, whereas in Nepal, women continue to fight. Many don't even know how to write. Is education not a basic human right? When they're put in sheds for getting their period, they count down the days until they can see the light. Sita knows all about the charity works that Rihanna has done, but Anuradha Kurla's work to alleviate sex trafficking is none of her concern. She doesn't care about how women in Nepal are slowly getting economically empowered as long as she is getting to earn. You see, no matter how educated Sita is, she'll never quite understand the importance of giving back to your country, to give a helping hand. If only her parents reminded her to go to the UK, but Thori, please don't abandon your country. Don't abandon your own ways. Your country needs you. The youth are supposed to lead us all the way. Now, I want to take you to the future. This time you're eating dal bhat on a sunny day. Your children then talk about how they hate Nepal and how they completely want to get away. But you correct them, you educate them, and you say, "Tun mato ma hami sabhi hurke ka chau, te mato ma thukera bidesko bhakti na hum." Thank you.